Hi there everyone, my name is Genesis, welcome back to my page, and as previously mentioned, if you haven't seen the other video, please go back. I'm covering top 10 health and food trends for 2018, and I said I'll be breaking them down into a series of 10 where I focus specifically on each one. Today we're going to be covering moringa. I shall not waste any time, we get straight into it. I'm going to be telling you about what it is, what it does in terms of the health benefits, and where you can get it from. So what is moringa then? Moringa is a plant that is native to places like Bangladesh, Afghanistan, Pakistan, but it's also widely grown in other tropics. It's also known as horseradish plant, bent tree, and drumstick tree as well. I like the name moringa. That's more than good enough for me. And the beauty about moringa is everything about this plant can actually be used for medicinal purposes. So from the actual flowers, the leaf, the bark, the root, everything has some form of a medicinal purpose, but commonly you'll find it's actually the leaves that are used, usually. And in terms of the benefits, now, moringa is a very special one because it's very nutrient dense, very packed in vitamins, minerals, amino acids. So it has your vitamin C, your vitamin A, vitamin E, calcium, iron, potassium, amino acids. Very vast array in terms of its nutritional content. Just to put things in perspective, right? So for example, it contains 4 times the amount of vitamin C as you would find in an orange, 4 times the amount of calcium and double the amount of protein as you'd find in milk, that being dairy milk. Also has 4 times the amount of vitamin A as you would find in a carrot, and also 3 times the amount of potassium as you'd find in a banana. As you can tell, it's sounding very robust. Actually kind of sounds like nature's multivitamin, doesn't it? Now, in terms of the benefits, now it's very high in antioxidants. Antioxidants are responsible for sort of fighting free radicals, which cause disease. Very good for anti-aging effects, good skin, all of that. Because when we talk about antioxidants, most people tend to think about, you know, oranges, lemons, you know, blueberries, pomegranate, red wine, vine, things like that. However, this one should be very much up there with them. It has a very high auric level, which is what's used to measure antioxidant levels, basically. And number 2, it helps to fight inflammation. Now, if you're working out, that's some sort of inflammation. If you're feeling ill, that's some sort of inflammation right there. So really, everybody could technically benefit from this, because at one point in our lives, we're all going to experience some form of inflammation, you see. And it does this by suppressing the actual inflammatory enzymes that are produced within the body when it's under some form of stress, for example. Number 3, it helps to reduce the actual symptoms of diabetes and poor cardiovascular health. Put simply, it lowers your blood sugar and lowers your cholesterol levels. So again, you know, that's one of, you know, the main sort of ailments in Western society, diabetes and poor cardiovascular health. A lot of people are on statins and things of that nature, so if you're looking for natural alternatives, this could be one for you right there. Brain health. Now, whether you're Dorothy 84 suffering from Alzheimer's, which studies have shown moringa does help with, or you are, you know, 16, you've got your exams coming up, or your university and you're studying, or you just, you know, you're an accountant, you work in the city and you're constantly crunching numbers and you're busy, everybody can benefit from improved brain health, is the point I'm trying to make here. It acts as a neuroenhancer, you see, moringa does, by normalizing the levels of serotonin, dopamine, as well as noradrenaline, which all play a role in stress, pleasure. Effectively, it's a very good one for mental health. Now, it also helps to protect the liver by actually normalizing the level of the enzymes produced by the liver. Put simply, say for example, you know, you like to have a drink on the weekend and you tend to, you know, really work your liver up. Liver is a very important organ. It's responsible for blood detoxification, lipid metabolism, and just generally breaking down all your nutrients. So you can imagine poor liver equals poor health after a while. And this will actually help you to help your liver to do its job effectively. Moringa helps with helping fight fatigue and tiredness due to the high iron content it has. Now, most people will at some point suffer from feeling tired and fatigued and things of that nature. This is a very good one to help with that. You know, for the ladies, it's another good one to help you replenish those iron levels in a more natural way, because a lot of the iron tablets on the market tend to actually be extremely constipating. So this is a very good alternative, if you like. Also helps with muscle growth due to the vast array of amino acids it contains. It does have all the essential amino acids, and these are the building blocks of protein, effectively. So for the vegans, vegetarians, this is a good alternative to meat. You are effectively cutting out the middleman in this equation, if you like. Where can I get it from? Well, most health food stores actually do have it now. Now, you've got to make sure, though, you are getting a good quality one, because if you get a poor standard one, then you are pretty much missing out on all those benefits that we just discussed. It comes in capsule form or tablet form, as well as powder form. Don't particularly like the tablets because they tend to have binders and fillers. Try and opt for powder or capsule, vegetable capsule, and then that way you know that everything you're getting is exactly that, just the moringa. Or powder form, then I like powder form because it's quite diverse. You can add it to your shakes, your smoothies, or you can add it to baking products and things like that as well. And there's two particular brands I like on the market at the moment. We've got Aduna and Minvita. They do good powder versions of that as well. But like I said, you can get them in tablet and capsule form as well. So that's moringa. Just to recap then, guys. It's a plant. Medicinal benefits are vast array, from high antioxidants, fighting inflammation, reducing symptoms of diabetes and poor cardiovascular health, improved brain health, protects your liver, also helps with fatigue and tiredness, and also helps with muscle growth. And you can get this in powder form as well as capsule form, ideally. So that was moringa. Please like, follow, all of that stuff. And yes, so this was the first one of a series of 10. If you want to find out about the rest of what's going to be trending for Food and Health 2018, please follow the page, and I'll see you in the next video.